Hey everyone, today I'm going to teach you about Siteswap notation. Siteswap notation is basically a way that jugglers denote certain tricks using numbers. Siteswap has some really cool uses that helps you precisely define what trick you're doing using only numbers. Because of this precision, you can type the numbers for a Siteswap pattern into a Siteswap generator, and an animated figure will perform that trick. The average of the numbers tells you how many balls you need to juggle that pattern. 501 adds up to 6, 6 divided by 3 is 2, and it's a 2-ball pattern. Just as a disclaimer, I'm going to teach you the basic version of Siteswap. There is a more technical version, but that never made much sense to me, and that never really helped me understand any Siteswap patterns. In Siteswap, odd numbers mean that the ball crosses from one hand to the other, and even numbers mean that it stays in one hand. The magnitude of the number indicates how high the ball is thrown. A 3 means that the ball goes from one hand to the other, and it goes about the height required for 3 balls. A 4 means that it stays in the same hand, and it would go about as high as you would need to throw to juggle 4 balls. A 5 means that the ball goes from one hand to the other, and it goes about as high as you would need to throw if you were juggling 5 balls. In general, it just keeps going on like that, but there are a few special numbers. A 2 means that you just hold the ball. A 1 means that you throw the ball in a quick horizontal line, like that. And a 0 means that your hand is empty. To show you how this works, I'm gonna break down a really common Siteswap, 4-2-3. 4-2-3 starts with a 4, which means that I'm gonna throw a ball straight up with my left hand. That ball will be this red ball. Next we're on the 2, which means we're on my right hand. Since it's a 2, that means that I'm not gonna do anything. I'm just gonna hold this yellow ball. Then I'm on my left hand again, which means I'm gonna throw a 3 pass from my left hand to my right hand. Then I'm on the 4 again, this time starting with my right hand, and then the pattern continues from there. Altogether, it looks like this.
4, 2, 3. 4, 2, 3. 4, 2, 3.
Next, I'm gonna show you how 501 works. 501 starts with a 5 throw, which means it's gonna go from my left hand to my right hand, and it's gonna be pretty high. Then it goes to my right hand, and my right hand has a 0, which means it's empty. Then we're back on my left hand again, and I'm gonna throw a short horizontal pass from my left hand to my right hand. That will be the pink ball. The pink ball will get to my right hand before the red ball does. And then the pattern starts over again, but this time it's starting from my right hand, and the pink ball is the 5, and the red ball is the 1. Altogether, it looks like this.
5-0-1. 5-0-1. 5-0-1.
The Siteswap for a 3-ball cascade is simply 3, the Siteswap for a 4-ball fountain is just 4, and the Siteswap for a 5-ball cascade is just 5. Not every trick can be represented with Siteswap. Mill's Mess has a Siteswap of 3, even though it looks a lot different from the regular cascade. Next week, I'll show you how to make your own juggling clubs at home. No hardware stores, no tools required.
Thanks for watching this video. If you want to see more videos like this, hit subscribe.